Well, I'm here with my mom, Lucille Maris, and she is getting near 92 years old, but was a stateside bride at the time my dad was flying B-24 bombers in World War II. If you've been listening to the podcast, you've already heard several of the stories that she has shared, and this is yet another that I'm hoping you enjoy. Dad got a Cocker Spaniel when he was in England, and I'm going to let Mom tell us a little bit about Blondie, and particularly about how Blondie got home to the United States after she had been over there during the wartime with my dad. So Mom, would you tell us about Blondie?
Well, my memory of Blondie, of course, the first I learned of her came through letters because that was the only way we communicated back during World War II. So it was probably 3 or 4 weeks after he actually had the dog that I got the news that he did have the dog. And Dad and some of his crew members were friends with a family in town. And this man of the family, they called the old mate, and he knew of a family that had this dog with the puppies, the litter of Cocker Spaniels, and he took Dad to visit. And of course, there was one that was blonde in color, and that Dad was choosing that one dog. And the first night he took it to the base with him, and apparently the dog was covered with fleas, and it was really kept all of the guys in the Quonset hut awake that first night. So he took it back into King's Lynn, where they were stationed there. And the old mate and his family took care of it and got rid of all the fleas, and I don't know the details of that, of course, but
she was a pretty small puppy, wasn't she?
She was 7, 8 weeks. Yeah, she was a very young puppy. After all, the guys couldn't handle her at the base with a lot of fleas. So anyway, I don't remember now how long she was stayed with the old maid in town and his wife, but probably a week or so while they got rid of the fleas, and then they took her back to the base. But that was my first knowledge of that, of course, was through letters from Jim that he had written about the dog and the fleas and all that sort of thing. So
I love the pictures that we have of her with Dad and with airplanes, and it's just so interesting. I hadn't ever really thought about soldiers having pets and Quonset huts on the base.
I think many men and women, when they're out of the States, acquire pets. That just seems to be the American thing for people to have pets. So I have read and seen many stories of such throughout the years. Anyway, the dog was a mascot of that Quonset hut. And the Quonset hut is the barracks of where they lived, is the Quonset hut. And she was a favorite of all of them. And of course, the other crews would watch her when Jim was in the air, and he, of course, never took her in the plane when they were on a mission, but he had taken her up in the plane when he was doing, and I don't know, but they were not combat missions. He had taken up and work on the engines or something, and he took her for a ride, but it was never through a mission that they would do that. So, but she was a good pet, and Jim and I had gotten acquainted with Cocker Spaniels through my sisters. Two of them had different Cocker Spaniels. So as we were dating, we would see these dogs and be with my sisters. And that's why the Cocker Spaniel was a favorite of ours. So,
which of my aunts had Cocker Spaniels?
Both Gladys and Mickey.
Okay.
And I had lived with each of them at different periods. So I lived with Mickey when we were first dating, and she had this really blonde one. And then later I lived with my sister Gladys and her husband, and they had a reddish one. But they were, both of those dogs were a part of our dating years. So that was an interesting part of our earlier years, but that's why we chose, I'm sure that's why he chose a Cocker Spaniel anyway. So
my understanding is that a dad came home from England and couldn't bring Blondie with him right away. So what is your memory of how Blondie got to the United States?
Well, first of all, before Dad left England, he flew down to London to take the dog down to a kennel that Spritz Dog Company had and would board a dog. And so Blondie was boarded in England then until they could find a ship that would bring her home, that the butcher would accept her as somebody he would help feed and take care of. So, but while she was there, she was quartered next to Eisenhower's dog. And so she was kind of along the elite.
So she was probably pretty pampered. He would have been a general at that time, right? General Eisenhower?
And of course, he was still in the European theater, and I don't know exactly where he was, but...
And for those of you, not that I'm a super great historian, but he later became a United States president.
True. Actually, and I saw him go down the street just beyond our house when he was in Lafayette, West Lafayette, many, many years ago as he was running for president. So.
Oh, wow. I didn't remember. I don't know if I ever knew that story.
Yeah. I just waved to him. Okay.
Mom is talking about West Lafayette, Indiana.
Right.
Okay.
And he was down the main street just half a block from our house. So.
Oh, that's pretty neat.
Yeah.
So Blondie was, she had to wait till she could get a ride home on a ship. And when you say the butcher, you're talking about the person
who was on the ship.
Who would actually cut up the meat for the meals.
Right.
That was the person that would have to actually feed any dogs that were on the
ship. But I assume it was a man in this case, would have to be the one to say, yes, I will take care of the dog.
Okay. So,
but she was probably there 2 to 3 months. I can't remember. I remember we had to send an extra check for her board somewhere along the way. So she was there longer than they had originally thought she might be. And when...
So where did you meet her stateside?
Well, that's... Yes. We were stationed... Jim was stationed at Smyrna, Tennessee. And we lived in Murfreesboro, which I don't remember how far, but it's half an hour from Murfreesboro anyway. And they called me to say that the dog was at the train station and that I was supposed to go pick her up. And so I expected to find a not well cared for dog, all matted and that sort of thing. And obviously, when I picked her up at the train station, she was very well-groomed and just hopped out and was so happy. So, of course, she didn't know me from anybody, but she was happy to be out of the cage and stuff. But she obviously did not spend a lot of time in that cage on the ship coming across either. And then later that evening, when Jim came home from the airbase, I was out front on the sidewalk, and I let go of him as he approached the house. I let go of the leash and she just ran and jumped up over his shoulders and was so happy to see him. So it was a fun time.
She definitely remembered him. So that
she definitely remembered him. And I don't know how we got the picture, but somehow or other we have the picture and it was in the newspaper of Murfreesboro at the time that of Jim and the dog and myself.
That reunion occurred.
Oh, that reunion, yeah. So
that's a neat story. And you had her for quite a long time after that, didn't you?
Yes. We after Jim was discharged from the military, we had her. Well, first of all, when we lived in Murfreesboro with her, we had two litter of puppies. One of them was 7, and I can't remember the number. The other was less. I think 5. And they were well accepted because she was a pedigree dog. And the American Cocker Spaniels were pretty inbred. Mm-hmm. So it was a good mix to have an English Cocker mm-hmm. to breed. And then Jim was discharged, so we left Murfreesboro and stayed in Champaign-Urbana for a while. I think she had another litter there because we also shared an apartment with the Doyles, mm-hmm. our friends the Doyles, local people that we'd grown up, well, been friends as teenagers with anyway. And we moved to Galesburg, Illinois, mm-hmm. and she had another litter of pups there, and which I have pictures of all these different litters of pups. But then we came back to Champaign-Urbana, Illinois. and eventually built a house, and she had a cancer that the surgery took her life. But she,
Oh.
and I, by that time I had had Kathy, our first child, and so that would have been, oh, several years.
Yeah.
I hadn't calculated ahead, so I can't tell you, but that was, Kathy was born in 51, so she would probably died in 53, and so we'd had her since Jim was in England, so.
Yeah, so she had a fairly long life. It wasn't like a 14 or 15-year-old life,
No,
but
but he would have gotten her in 44,
yeah.
so she was,
Okay. What a neat story.
it was a fun adventure.
And I was hearing parallels in my own life as you were telling that story. I'm thinking, well, it's no wonder I'm not afraid to ship rabbits across the country to buyers, or I never have actually imported a Connemara pony, but I certainly considered it on many different occasions when I was raising Connemaras. So apparently it's been in my blood for a long time, and I didn't even
Long before
realize
you were
it.
born.
Because that what you were describing to me sounded kind of complicated, that to get her home from England, that you had to
Well,
find the kennel to keep her for
yeah.
several months, and you had to get them paid, and you had to get her a ride on a ship. Couldn't
Yeah,
you didn't fly her home like we would today.
right. Oh, right.
So
And we had no idea of how she was being cared for
yeah,
all that time. It was just,
you didn't have
yeah.
cell phones where you could
How's my
text a
dog?
photo.
No, how's my dog? Or pictures? No,
Yeah.
no. But
Wow.
I just
Okay.
remember being marveling at her condition when I picked her up at that train station, because I really expected her to be not groomed and, all matted and all that. And she was beautiful.
Yeah, that's awesome. Well, Mom, thank you for sharing that story. That's a really sweet story. I guess it touches my heart, especially since I'm such an animal lover. And you've
Wonder where you
shared,
got that
I think it came from both of you. Folks, I hope you've enjoyed it as well, and you'll hear more of these stories coming in future episodes. So thank you again, Mom, for sharing that with us, and what a wonderful memory from a time long ago in World War II.